lines.
Did you ever suggest anything to, for Mr. Anthony to make inquisitions as to whether her lawyer was properly representing Casey Anthony?
No, sir. They complained to us quite a bit about it, but we never asked her, them to go talk to her to ask whether you were properly representing her.
I'd like to refer your attention to page 40, lines 24 and 25, and that goes on to the next page, up to line 3.
Okay.
Can you take a look at that? Do you then ask him if perhaps she had another attorney that might go and talk to the prosecutors that this whole thing could get resolved?
Yes, sir.
Now, on August 14, 2008, you then actually picked up George Anthony at a Publix, did you not?
Yes, sir.
And when you went and picked him up, you told Mr. Anthony that you were doing this because Ms. Casey Anthony had reached out.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And that this was not part of the investigation.
Okay.
Does that sound correct to you?
I don't have the transcript in front of me, but I do remember going and picking Mr. Anthony up.
Would you have lied to Mr. Anthony and told him that this was not part of the investigation of his daughter? Let me finish the question. This was not part of the investigation of his daughter.
I would have lied to him, but the visitation was set up so that he could go talk to her. They had made several requests for us to do this. Our only objection was that we would not allow them to meet alone, and that the jail would have some concerns about that as well.
But you were doing this because you were a nice guy?
Well, we were doing it at their request, but certainly anything if we had gotten something of evidentiary value, we would have used it, or we would have turned it over to the prosecutor.
So when you said that this was not part of the investigation, was that completely true?
Well, it was true that it wasn't part of the investigation with respect to us investigating it, but if something had come from it that was of investigative value, we would have turned it over.
Okay. How long have you been a police officer?
Since April of 1979.
How many years is that?
More than 30.
And in your 30 years of being a law enforcement officer, have you ever set up a private visit between someone who you arrested and a family member at the jail?
No, sir.
I think this is a good stopping point, Judge.
Okay, you have more questions for him?
I do, but I think,
okay.
I think it'll take a while, so.
What's your definition of a while? I'm just trying to figure out.
Much longer than three minutes.
No, I know it's much longer than 3 minutes. I'm trying to gauge for tomorrow, Mr. Baez.
For tomorrow, how long would you say? He wants to talk in secret. We think 2 hours, Judge.
Okay. Okay, Sergeant Allen, you hereby excuse until tomorrow. We'll start at 9 a.m.
Yes, sir.
Judge, may we approach about a scheduling matter?
Yes. Is moved. And the state's motion in limited would be next, right?
Yes, they've agreed to remind me of something.
Okay, then after that, there's the state's motion to strike the defendant's supplemental window witness list.
It is related to that. Right?
Then I think it's related to that, so you can come back,
back tomorrow.
Yes?
I will add that. This, the whole, I don't know if.
Well, let me ask you this. How long do you need for your motion?
Not long, Your Honor.
Well,
about 10 minutes max, it will be quick.
The strike Kathy Bialich from the witness list.
I can tell you that was set on the calendar without coordination with Mr. Mason myself.
Well, that's not a very difficult motion. Either it is or it ain't. So we will schedule that at 8:45 tomorrow morning.
Okay. And Mr. Thomas will be back with Mr. Honor being with him, but we'll have him here. So Judge Tammy Gaffney for the county, we have one Orange County employee left and we'll have clarification on whether or not that needs to come back to the excuse
that we see. Who is that?
Cindy Corrado. That's the witness that you limited to impeachment purposes.
Yes, she has to come back. You got an idea whether you're going to use her, Mr. Bayer?
When?
Okay, folks, this court will be in recess until 8:45 a.m.